Hey guys, in this quick tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can sort your inventory array. And first we're going to do it by item type. So for example, if you have armor, weapons, or food, or anything else, we're only going to display one type of item. And then we're going to sort it by some value. So for example, price or weight. And I already have some basic setup done here. So if I open my inventory, I do have inventory array display with different types of fruit. So for example, I have bananas, I have pears and apples, and as you can see, all of them have different price and weight. And then I also created these two buttons that don't do anything, but what I wanted to do that if I press this first button, I'm going to display only bananas, for example. So to do this, it is quite easy. I'll go to the inventory widget. Here, basically, I do have this inventory array, which is just array of structs that hold all the information like name, price, weight, icon, and a fruit type, which is just an enumerator with apples, pears, and bananas. So that is pretty standard setup. And I also have the build inventory, which just creates like the item slot widgets for each item. So now, in this button, I want to just add text quickly so I know what I'm sorting. So here I'm going to just change this text to bananas. And then in the graph, when I select this button one and do onClicked event, I want to display only bananas. So we'll get inventory, do for each loop. And as I said, this is quite simple. We just need to break this struct. And then if this fruit type equals enumerator, this one here, and if it equals bananas, we will hold B and click, we'll do branch. Then we need to create some temporary array. So from this inventory, we can promote to variable, and this one will be temp array. Or we could call it banana array or something, but I'll just leave it a temporary array. Get it, and we'll add to it all these bananas that we find. So this array element. So this new inventory will only have bananas inside. And then when this for loop is completed, I can just call my build inventory because it has the inventory that I can connect. So from here, I'm just going to do build inventory and it will display this temporary array. So now let's see if it works. If I open the inventory and here I click on these bananas, as you can see, I'm only displaying the bananas, nothing else. So then you could create multiple buttons or icons, and if you click on it, so there will be the whole inventory array and you can just generate the whole inventory again, or you can select apples or pears or any item type you want. So this one, first one, as I said, this one was easy. Now second button, what I want to do is when I click on it, I will organize all the fruit by weight or price. So this one, we will go to inventory again. We will select this button number 2 and do onClicked event. I'll just quickly add some text to it as well. To the second button, and this one will be, let's do price. And to do that, first we need to do for loop. So regular for loop. And we need to know the last index, so how many times we're going to be looping. So we'll get inventory and do length. And then since this index starts with the index 0, we need to just subtract 1 from here. And this will be our last index, so it will loop through the whole inventory. But then we need to do second for loop. So for loop. And this time what we need to do is, let's move this up so it's not confusing. And we need to, from the length, we need to subtract this index. So as this index on the first loop is increasing, this value will decrease. And we will also subtract again from it 2. I'll explain in a second why we're subtracting 2. And this will be the last index of the second array. And then in this second for loop, we need to get this inventory and we're going to get a copy, which will return the struct on this index. and also on this index plus one. So the item and item next to it. So get this one again. And the reason why we're subtracting two from here is because the last, again, there is a last index, basically it starts with zero, so there is one less item. But the second one is because if we're comparing the, we're comparing always the last index plus the index after that, so we don't need to do last two. And this one will just keep increasing, and the items that we need to organize will keep decreasing, because we will always switch at least minimum the last item with the prices, and then it will just basically get organized from the backwards to forwards. So I know it doesn't make much sense, but we will see how it actually works. And then from this, we're going to break item data and just compare this price. So if this price is greater than this price, what we need to do is get this inventory, and we're going to do swap array elements, and we need to swap this index, and again this index plus one, so you can just drag it like that directly. So these last two will be swapped, and then it will go again. So this is pretty much the whole setup. If you want to have, so this will be price ascending, so it will go up. If you want to have it all the way around, you can do down, so less than, and just connect that to condition. I'll show you how to do both with like a flip-flop. So compile and save. And now this will just swap. We also need to display it one more time. So after it's completed, this one here, the main one, we're going to again build inventory. And this time we'll just call regular inventory. So if I play the game, inventory, and now this time you can see the price of apples is the lowest. If I click on a price, apples are first, then bananas, and then pears. All right, so that's how you organize by price. You can do the same thing by weight. But I also want to do, when I click on it the second time, it will go all the way around. So apples will be last and so on. So to do that, we can just do flip-flop on this click. We will create new Boolean variable. So this one we can promote to variable, and this one will be ascending, or is ascending, which means it's going up, or the other variant is descending, but you just need to connect it to this flip-flop, and both of these will go through here. So when we press it first time, this will switch this variable, and when we press it second time, it will be false, and so on. And here in the end, we're going to do select from this condition. So find select node, and we'll connect this is ascending as this index. And if it's true, I think we need to use this one. We'll see, maybe I'm doing it other way around. And if it's false, we're going to do less than this price. Right, so it will switch it all the way around. So now, when I play the game again, press price, organize it one way, press price second time, there we go, apples are in the end. As many times as you want, and as you can see, it's very quick to organize it. And you can set up again, you can do weight next to it, it will straight away organize it by weight. You can select bananas only, and if bananas at different price, you can also organize it by price. But as you can see, by price just returns to me to regular array. Right, and this is how you sort your inventories. So, hope you like this video, and have a nice day.